Hello, this is Lovely Lovebird Designs. In this tutorial, I will be showing you how to make a wizard on the rainbow loom. He also has a staff, a beard, and a hat, and hair on the back. If you don't want to make the hair, you can just have him just like that also. And I'm going to show you just on a single loom, and his head and his hat are on one loom. And then this is another loom, and then I'll show you how to attach it at the end. So let's get started. Also, I used dark blue and yellow as an accent, and gray and white for the beard. You can use all gray or all white, or you can use all blue or any color you'd like. In this tutorial, I'm going to use blue with dark red instead of yellow. And silver looks really pretty too. Now we're going to start on making the beard, because you have to attach the beard to the head. So we'll do the beard first. I'm going to use gray and white. So it's a single loom, straight configuration, and everything is single banded. So I'm going to use white, single band here. I'm going to use gray in the middle and white over here. Then I'm going to put gray over here. If you don't want to use gray, you can just use all white also. And then I'm going to use white and gray. Then I'm going to use white over here, gray, and then I'm going to make a diagonal of white. So this is the thick part of the beard. Now we're going to the skinnier part of the beard, which would be two colors. So I'm going to use white here and gray. Now gray and white. Okay, now white over here and gray. It's just a pattern. Now gray and white. Okay, and one more white and gray. Okay, so it's total of 1, 2, 3 rows of three, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows of double. Capping band, I'm going to use white, or you can use gray. I'm going to wrap it around three times these two pins. Okay, now we're going to put some structural bands. I'm going to make different colors, so I used white here. I'm going to use gray here. Wrap it around two times, single band. I'm going to use white here, wrap it around twice, gray, wrap it around twice, white, same, twice. Okay, this one will be gray. Okay, now this is going to be a triangle band of white, and that is your beard. Now we can loop it, and I'm just going straight forward with this row. I will start on this row. Okay, this is the upper band. We're going to grab this one and bring it on the diagonal and loom these up. Okay, now we're going to start here in the middle. Okay, this is your beard. Now you can take it off the loom. If you have a toothpick or another hook, you can hold it there. I'm going to just take it off the loom with the hook right here. You have to set this aside. And this is your beard. Okay. Now, if you have another hook, you can place on there, but I have toothpicks, so I'm just going to place it this way and set it aside. Okay, just like that. Okay, so now we have the beard. Now we're going to make the hat and the head. And this is going to be on one loom. And I'm going to use dark blue and red. So, first we'll pick out my dark blue. And that will be a single band. If you want to make it just all blue, then you can put a double. But I'm going to put, instead of yellow, I'm going to put the red. So take one blue and one red and place it right on, right there. Okay, then we're going to do another blue and a red, or whatever color you'd like, and place it on a diagonal. Now I'm just going to do a double blue right here. Then I'm going to do another double blue here, and this is just basically the same kind of pattern every other to make the colors a little bit more vibrant. So now I'm going to take another red and another blue. Place it right there, and now I'm going to go another diagonal with blue, just a double blue. Okay, now I'm going to put red and blue over here. Okay, blue here, double blue. And a red and blue here. Okay, now I'm going to do double blue here, red and blue here, and a blue here, double. Okay, now I'm going to do red and blue here. Blue here. And a red and blue here. To finish the hat off, we're going to do one more row. So blue here. Red and blue, and another blue. Okay, now we're going to work on the face. Yeah, we'll be using Rainbow Loom Skin Tones, and it's the light peach color, so it's a double, and we'll be placing it on this pin and all the way across. Okay, another row. Another row. Okay, and then we're going to make the chin area. To place one in the middle. Then diagonal, and another diagonal. And then I'm going to make the neck, and I'm going to use a double. Place it just like that. And then you can make this a triple also for a stronger neck also. I'll put a triple. But if you want to just do double, you can do double also. And then capping band. Place a double and wrap it around 3 times. Okay. Now we'll be putting the rim of the hat. The rim of the hat is going to be 1 blue color wrapped around 4 times. Then take 1 of the red, or the color you're choosing, 1 blue, and place just like that. Okay, and we're going to place that right here. Push these down. Okay, one more. I'm going to place over here. So, 1 blue wrapped 4 times around. Take 1 blue and 1 red. And just like that, and place that on this pin. Okay, this will bring the hat out and make a rim. Also, I'm going to show you right now how to make, I just showed you this, and I'm going to show you this part. Okay? Also, you can use that way. This part is actually a double band. So you can keep it like this and it'll be a little thinner, but I'm going to actually change it right now to make it match this. So I'm actually going to, this one is a double color as the capping band and then a single. So I'll just change it. Here's the double. And wrap it around 3 times. And then take your other color, a double of the solid. This will just make it a little thicker and bigger. So if you want a thinner rim, you can keep it like that. But if you want a thicker one, I'm just going to change it like that. You see the difference? I think it'll look better, thicker. So take your colored one, wrap it around 3 times. Take a double of your solid color. place it just like that, and then we'll place it on that pin. Okay, and then I call these poof balls, but there's one here, and one here, and there's also one couple in the middle. So we're going to make the ones in the middle first. Same technique. Take the two colors that you want, wrap it around three times. Take another set of the two colors, wrap it around three times. This is like the only tricky part of the whole hat, is just putting this rim on. So now I take a single, and place these poof balls on that band. So you got one, and here's number two. Now I'm going to place it on this pin, and then place the other on this pin. Separate the ball so it's in the middle. So here's one and here's two. Okay, and then we're going to make it poofy on this band, and this band. So same technique. Take a single and another single of the color, wrap around three times. Place it on this pin. Okay, just like that. Now we're going to make another one and put it on this pin. So both colors, wrap around three times. Place it on the middle pin. Okay, and one more right here. And that is the rim of your hat. You can see it's already thicker in this section. Okay, now we're going to work on the eyes, and I'm going to use black, and I wrap it around six times. Okay, another black. You can use beads also. Okay, now I'm going to take a skin tone and pull the eyes on this band. Okay, there's one. And two. Okay, I'm going to place it right here. One right there. And on this pin. And you can separate them. Okay, in my people, I also put a nose. If you don't want to place a nose, that's okay. You can see a little nose right here. If you don't want to do this, you don't have to. But I do a regular skin tone, wrap six times around. Take another skin tone. your nose on that band. Okay, and then I place that right here. Okay, so it looks just like that. Now we're going to be placing the beard. So we now have the nose, and now we're going to place the beard. Take the beard that you had before, and this is an easy trick to do. It's not that hard. Place your band basically upside down. Put your beard upside down. We're also going to be placing it on this pin, same that you have your nose. Okay, now I'm taking the middle gray section. I'm placing it on the middle pin. And now I'm going to take this white band. And place it just like that. So it's going to look like this. Okay? Okay, I just want to make one little correction. This is the nose, and I actually want to place it on top. So I'm just going to take off this gray band. Okay, and then place this on top of that band, of the pin. So I just took this, the nose, and placed it on top. Now I'm going to replace the beard band, and there you have it. Now I'm going to make these structural bands, which are easy. So take a single blue and then make a triangle. Take another single blue triangle and one more triangle, and right here I want to take a single, stretch it out, twist it, and place it on here to make the hat a little bit more pointy. Then we're going to do another single twisted on this band, and that is your structural bands. So you have the nose now over here, and this is your rim, and it should look like this. So you can take a moment and make sure it looks like this. Now we can start looping. I'm going to take this triple. And loop it forward. Now I'm grabbing this band. This is the uppermost. Yep. Okay, now I'm grabbing this one, which is the next. Okay, and then the middle. Okay, now I will be grabbing this and pulling it. I'm going to just do these three rows. Right on top. Right on top. And on top. Now place your finger over here and pull your beard right on top of that band. Same over here. It's going to go on top. And now you just attached your beard. Now we're going to bring this band forward. Now place your nose right in the middle of this band. Like that. Now we'll grab this one and loop forward. Now these are going to be the same technique as the beard. So we're going to loop this forward. I'm going to do all three skin tones first. Now you can pull this out, and the bands that we looped on here, that we wrapped around, pull them out and place them forward on the skin tone bands. The pom-poms, you see now it looks like this. Now we're going to grab this one also. You can actually go under with the hook. Grab the bands, bring it forward on top of your skin tones. And same here. Just like that, easy. Okay, make sure nothing's left there and it's all there. And I'm missing one more little piece of red. Just like that. So now we can continue to loop and should be all blue. This one is red. I put red, a double red here, that's okay. So I'm going all the way down and finding the last two bands and moving forward. Okay, so now we're coming to the smaller part. We're going to loop this forward. Okay, now I want to grab this one because it's laying on top. So we'll do the diagonal. And now this middle. And we're just going to keep on looping forward. Now the diagonal. And finally the last. Now I'm going to take a double of my solid color, or you can use the red. Make a slip knot. On top. Okay, and it should look like this. I'm going to take it off the loom, and you have to, this will be a little bit mangled when you take it off the loom, but I'm going to show you how to fix it. Take it off one pin at a time. Okay, now stretch out the hat. You can see it's already getting pointed. Stretch out your side bands. Okay, so stretch these out, the side of the hat. Bring your pom-pom that was on the face up. Here's another pom-pom, so there's three. Now you have the pom-poms in the middle. Bring them out. So that's all continuous row. Then you have your eyes. Bring them out. Okay. Then you have your nose. My nose is over here now, so I'm going to place it back in the middle. And if you don't have, if you didn't put the nose in, then it's one less thing you have to worry about. I'm going to bring my nose out, just like that. Bring the beard down. And you can see how it's attached now. Now you have a neck with that capping band. And you have a head. Now I'm going to make a body to go along with it, and the hair extensions if you want hair in the back. And to hide this upper band, I just tuck in the back. I just tuck them. Okay, so now it's pointy. Okay, and then we're going to work on the body next. Okay, now the body is the head attached to the neck area via the capping band. So first I'm going to make the body, and then I'm going to put the head on top. And then we can tie it and hide the knot in the back. And then I'll show you how to do the hair if you want hair, and the staff. So I'm going to use the same colors as before, the blue and the red. I'm going to place a double blue here. I'm going to place another double blue here. And then another double blue. Okay, now I'm going to work down 9 bands down. I'm making his body a little longer, so he's a little taller. So now I'm going to do 1 red and 1 blue. Then a double blue, which I already have. And a double red, a red and a blue. Now I'm going to place a blue, just double blue. Now a red and a blue. and a blue, double blue. One of the bands broke. Okay, so now I'm going to place red and a blue. Place the red on top so you can see it better. Just a double blue. Breaking. Okay, and a red and a blue. Got to make six more of this pattern. Double blue. Here's a red and a blue. And a double. Okay, now a red and blue. Just blue. And a red and blue. Now just blue, red and blue, and a blue. And another red and blue. And a red and blue. And a double blue, red and blue. And a blue. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One more row. Okay, now I'm going to make his arms, and I want him to have only his hands showing. If you want to change this and make this band skin tone and make more of like an wrist, you can do that too. I like it just have a long flowing robe, so I'm just going to show his hands. So I just take a single skin tone, wrap it around four times. Then I'm going to take a double blue . Place it on just like that. Then a single red and a single blue. I'm going to make his arm four bands length. So this is number two. Then another double blue, so that would be number three, and then another red and blue. And that would be four. Okay, I'm going to place it on this pin. Okay, and now I'm going to do the same skin tone, wrap four times around. then a double blue, a red and a blue, another double blue, another red and blue. Okay, I'm going to put it on this pin. Okay, now I'm going to use the same technique as the hat to make the bottom, because it's very flowing. I'm going to put a little extension on the side too. If you don't want to do this part, it's a little bit more complicated. You can just keep it straight and put capping bands and then you're all done. But I like to have his garment stretching and flowing. So I'm just going to take one. I'm going to do the side extensions first. Take a single blue, wrap it around four times. Then I'm going to take another blue and red. Place it just like that. And then another double blue. So now I'm going to place the capping band right here. And that pin, and then this band right here. Okay, that's going to make it a little bit more flowing. We're going to pull it out, and that's your little side extension. So we'll do one more. Wrap four times around. And take the colored band and the blue, and then take another double blue. And put my cap and band here. And my other band here. Push these down. Now I'm going to place the colored bands. One blue, one colored. Wrap three times around. This is, we're going to do the pom-poms again. One colored, one same, three times around. So you got two pom-poms. Then I'm going to take my blue, place them on there, place that right there, and then the other end, and your pom-poms in the middle, and the band on top. Now I'm going to place capping bands here. And I just did regular capping bands for these. Place it down. I'm going to do a little bit more frilly and take the same, the two colors, wrapped three times around. I'm going to do that one again. And three. I'm going to take another one, the two colors, wrap three times around, okay, and then finally this one. Wrap three times. Okay, so basically that's your hat rim right here. plus side extensions. Now we're going to just do simple triangles. For the structural bands, these are singles. Okay, and that's what it should look like. Now we're going to loom this forward. Okay, I'm going to start on this side, and I'm just grabbing the lower two bands. That's all I'm grabbing. Okay, everything is lower two bands. And just loop it forward. Okay, now we're gonna do the middle. Forward, and finally the left. I remember, lower two bands. Okay, now we're going to grab this lower band and bring it to the side. Right here in the middle. I'm going to grab this band and bring it in the middle. Okay, that is your body. This is your capping band right here from before. You can either place it directly on here and we can tie it, or you can actually take these off and put it in the middle too. I'm gonna just place these back on here just to hide the neck area a little bit in the outfit. And I'm going to place the capping band that we made right on that pin. Okay, just like that. And then I'll bring the outfit forward. You don't have to do this, you can just place that right on top. Okay, let me find the band that I had. just like that. Okay, so now I have the neck. I only did that to hide the neck a little bit, but you don't really have to, because the beard hides it anyway. But you can just place this on top of that band too. It's your preference. Okay, I'm going to take a double of my blue. I'm going to make a slip knot to connect the head to the body. A lot of bands. So just take your time. Okay, and now I have a slip knot. If you want to make another slip knot on the other side to make it more secure, you can. I'm going to do that too, just to make it better so nothing moves. You don't have to do this, just to make it more secure. Now we can take it off the loom. Be careful here, it's a lot of bands. And finally the middle. Now we have the neck right here. Plus these bands. You can actually hide these bands and just wrap it around his head. I'll say two times. Pull it down. Stretch out the arm. Beard. Outfit. Now the bottom, you have the side extensions. Everything's a little bit hidden. Try to find the extensions that you had that you made. Pull them out to the side. Here's my extensions. Pull them out. Just like that. Here's my other extensions. Them out. Now I have the cap and bands, the little pom-poms in the middle. You can rearrange them to make it more flowing. And there you go, the bottom. See how it comes out a little bit. Okay, and there is your wizard. Now, you can keep him like that, or I'm going to show you also how to make the hair in the back. So if you want him just like that, keep him and you're all done, or you want hair, I'll show you how to do the hair. The hair is really simple. It's only 6 bands, and then I tie it in the back. So I'll show you how to do the hair, and then I'll show you how to do the staff. So this is just a single band. I'm going to use just all white this time to make the back of the hair white. You can do the white and gray if you want. I'm going to go down about 10 bands. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nine and ten. You can make his hair as long or short as you'd like, but I'm going to make long hair this time. Your capping band is about 3 times around. These are all single bands. So I will show you. Just a single band going down. I'm going to show you just 2 rows, and then it's up to you to make 6 of them. And then I already pre-made 4. And I'll show you how to place it on the head. Remember, this is 10 rows, 10, so it goes down to like around here. If you want it longer, you can place another 2 and it'll be longer. If you want it shorter, you can just place 5, or however you'd like. So another capping band 3 times around. And just loop forward. And we'll go to the second. Okay, I'm going to take these off. And these are 2 strands. Make 4 more, and then I'm going to show you how to put them on the figure. So you can pause right now. Okay, so now I made 6 all together. And if you want to have hair on the back, I will show you right now. There's these skin tone bands right here. There's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'm going to take this off. I'm going to take the first skin tone double band in the back of the head. Place it just like that. Place your white band and then pull it through, and now you can make a slip knot. And that's 1 strand. So I'm basically just making slip knots. And here is another one. Your double over here. So we have 1 here, 2 here. I'm going to place these a little bit farther back so you can see better. Okay, I'm going to take this one off, get my hook, go underneath, place the white band back on top, place it through, and then make a slip knot, and here's number 2. Now we're gonna make another one over here. You don't even need the hook for this too. You can just do it with your hands and make knots. Okay, and then we're gonna grab this one. Pull the white through your skin tone and slip knot. Okay, we have your final one right here. Final knot. Okay, so now you have hair in the back, and what I do, I take all these loose slip knots, put them underneath, like on the back of the neck, gather them up. Okay, so you have all of them. I tie them. Just do another little slip knot so it stays back there and out of the way. Okay, so I'll just place it right back, put the hair down. And now he has hair. See how simple that is? You can pull the hair in the front, make a ponytail, whatever you like. And this will mesh with the rest of the hair in the back too. Okay, now I'm going to show you how to make this staff that goes along with him. The original wizard that I have, this is the original, he's a little shorter. And he has metallic bands. His staff is actually a safety swab with gold bands wrapped around it and all the way up and down. So if you wanted to do a safety swab and wrap the bands around it, this is how it will look. So you have a big section here and a section here for the cotton, and it just gets all wrapped around. But I'm going to show you how to make one on the loom. And it will look like this. And if your staff is a little wobbly, you can take a toothpick and tie it to the staff so it's more straight. That's what I did with this one. So I'm going to show you how to do that. I use gold for that wizard. I'm going to use brown for this one. So I think this is Rainbow Loom Burgundy color. I'm going to use a double. Place it just on top. Then another double. And place it like that. Okay, now everything else are single twists and going down the loom. I'm making brown to more look like a stick. The other one is gold. You can do any color you'd like. Okay, now band that three times around, and we can start looping. Now we're going to grab this diagonal band. Okay, now I'm going to take a double band. Okay, make a slip knot. Now this is the top part. And then I'm going to wrap this around. Wrap it around a couple times. Just the base. And now you have the top part. Now I'm going to make this longer. And I'm going to do another section, single twisted, all the way down. So you have all the way down. Now, this is your capping band. I actually want to break that. I don't want to use that. I just want to make a continuous staff. So I'm going to place my hook right through the last stitch. Take that capping band, break it. I don't need it anymore. So it was just a holder. Now, place this as your capping band. just like that. And now we're going to loop forward. Okay, now you can take this off the loom. Okay, now you have a very long staff. Make a slip knot at the end. Just like that. Same as before, just put it back on the, you can actually just hide it within. So I'm going to put the hook right through again. Take the ends. And just pull it through so it's hidden a little bit, just like that. Okay, so this staff is pretty straight. These bands cooperated. What I want to do is make him hold it. So I'm going to take his hand. Take my hook. Just to stretch it out. And pull his staff right through. Okay, I'm going to place it just like that, right in the middle. Now, if your bands are not straight like this one, it's very easy to fix it. Just take a you can take a Q-tip and just cut the ends off, or the stick, and you just place it right in the back. Tie bands here, tie bands here, and tie bands here. Just one band wrapped like three times around, and it'll make it straight. And very simple. I hope you like the tutorial. Here is the wizard in red, the one we just made with his wooden staff. And then here is the golden staff with the toothpick, just to make it more straight. With long hair, you don't have to add the hair also. And I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Please subscribe to Lovely Lovebird Designs, and we'll see you soon. Okay, another row. Another row. And then we're going to make the chin area. To place one in the middle. Then diagonal. And another diagonal. And then I'm going to make the neck. And I'm going to use a double. it just like that. And then you can make this a triple also for a stronger neck also. I'll put a triple, but if you want to just do double, you can do double also. And then capping band. Place a double and wrap it around 3 times. Okay, now we'll be putting the rim of the hat. The rim of the hat is going to be 1 blue color wrapped around 4 times. Then take 1 of the red, or the color you're choosing, 1 blue, and place just like that. Okay, and we're going to place that right here. Push these down. Okay, 1 more. We're going to place over here. So, 1 blue wrapped 4 times around. Take 1 blue and 1 red. And just like that. And place that on this pin. Okay, this will bring the hat out and make a rim. Also, I'm going to show you right now how to make... I just showed you this, and I'm going to show you this part. Okay? Also, you can use that way. This part is actually a double band. So you can keep it like this, and it'll be a little thinner, but I'm going to actually change it right now to make it match this. So I'm actually going to... This one is a double color as the capping band, and then a single. So I'll just change it. Here's the double. And wrap it around 3 times. And then take your other color, a double of the solid. This will just make it a little thicker and bigger. So if you want a thinner rim, you can keep it like that. But if you want a thicker one, I'm just going to change it like that. You see the difference? I think it'll look better, thicker. So take your colored one, wrap it around 3 times. Take a double of your solid color. Place it just like that, and then we'll place it on that pin. Okay, and then I call these poof balls, but there's 1 here, 1 here, and 1 here. And there's also 1 couple in the middle. So we're going to make the ones in the middle first. Same technique. Take the 2 colors that you want. Wrap it around 3 times. Take another set of the 2 colors. Wrap it around 3 times. This is like the only tricky part of the whole hat, is just putting this rim on. So now I take a single, and place these poof balls on that band. So you got 1, and here's number 2. Now I'm going to place it on this pin. And then place the other on this pin. Separate the ball so it's in the middle. So here's one and here's two. Okay, and then we're going to make it poofy on this band, and this band. So same technique. Take a single and another single of the color. Wrap it on three times. Place it on this pin. Okay, just like that. Now we're going to make another one and put it on this pin. So both colors, wrap around three times. Place it on the middle pin. Okay, and one more right here. And that is the rim of your hat. You can see it's already thicker in this section. Okay, now we're going to work on the eyes, and I'm going to use black, and I wrap it around six times. Okay, another black. You can use beads also. Okay, now I'm going to take a skin tone and pull the eyes on this band. Okay, there's one. And two. Okay, I'm going to place it right here. One right there. And on this pin. And you can separate them. Okay, in my people, I also put a nose. If you don't want to place a nose, that's okay. You can see a little nose right here. If you don't want to do this, you don't have to. But I do a regular skin tone, wrap six times around. Take another skin tone. Place your nose on that band. And then I place that right here. Okay, so it looks just like that. Now we're going to be placing the beard. So we now have the nose, and now we're going to place the beard. Take the beard that you had before, and this is an easy trick to do. It's not that hard. Place your band basically upside down. Put your beard upside down. We're also going to be placing it on this pin, same that you have your nose. Okay. Now I'm taking the middle gray section. I'm placing it on the middle pin. And now I'm going to take this white band. And place it just like that. So it's going to look like this. Okay? Okay, I just want to make one little correction. This is the nose, and I actually want to place it on top. So I'm just going to take off this gray band. Okay, and then place this on top of that band, of the pin. So I just took this, the nose, and placed it on top. Now I'm going to replace the beard band, and there you have it. Now I'm going to make these structural bands, which are easy. So take a single blue and then make a triangle. Take another single blue triangle and one more triangle, and right here I want to take a single, stretch it out, twist it, and place it on here to make the hat a little bit more pointy. Then we're going to do another single twisted on this band, and that is your structural bands. So you have the nose now over here, and this is your rim, and should look like this. So you can take a moment and make sure it looks like this. Now we can start looping. I'm going to take this triple. And loop it forward. Now I'm grabbing this band. This is the uppermost. Yep. Okay, now I'm grabbing this one, which is the next. Okay, and then the middle. Okay, now I will be grabbing this and pulling it. I'm going to just do these three rows. Right on top. Right on top. And on top. Now place your finger over here and pull your beard right on top of that band. Same over here. It's going to go on top. And now you just attached your beard. Now we're going to bring this band forward. Now place your nose right in the middle of this band. Like that. Now we'll grab this one and loop forward. Now these are going to be the same technique as the beard. So we're going to loop this forward. I'm going to do all three skin tones first. Now you can pull this out, and the bands that we looped on here, that we wrapped around, pull them out and place them row this is the upper band. We're going to grab this one and bring it on the diagonal and loom these up. Okay, now we're going to start here in the middle. Okay, this is your beard. Now you can take it off the loom. If you have a toothpick or another hook, you can hold it there. I'm going to just take it off the loom with the hook right here. You have to set this aside. And this is your beard. Okay. Now, if you have another hook, you can place on there, but I have toothpicks, so I'm just going to place it this way and set it aside. Okay, just like that. Okay, so now we have the beard. Now we're going to make the hat and the head, and this is going to be on one loom, and I'm going to use dark blue and red. So first, we'll pick out my dark blue, and that will be a single band. If you want to make it just all blue, then you can put a double, but I'm going to put, instead of yellow, I'm going to put the red. So take one blue and one red and place it right there. Okay, then we're going to do another blue and a red, or whatever color you'd like, and place it on a diagonal. Now I'm just going to do a double blue right here. Then I'm going to do another double blue here, and this is just basically the same kind of pattern every other, to make the colors a little bit more vibrant. So now I'm going to take another red and another blue. Place it right there. And now I'm going to go another diagonal with blue. Just a double blue. Okay, now I'm going to put red and blue over here. Okay, blue here, double blue, and a red and blue here. Okay, now I'm going to do double blue here, red and blue here. And a blue here, double. Okay, now I'm going to do red and blue here. Blue here. And a red and blue here. Finish the hat off, we're going to do one more row. So blue here, red and blue, and another blue. Okay, now we're going to work on the face. Okay, I will be using Rainbow Loom Skin Tones. And it's the light peach color, so it's a double, and we'll be placing it on this pin and all the way across. Hello, this is Lovely Lovebird Designs. In this tutorial, I will be showing you how to make a wizard on the rainbow loom. He also has a staff, a beard, and a hat, and hair on the back. If you don't want to make the hair, you can just have him just like that also. And I'm going to show you just on a single loom, and his head and his hat are on one loom. And then this is another loom, and then I'll show you how to attach it at the end. So let's get started. Also, I used dark blue and yellow as an accent, and gray and white for the beard. You can use all gray or all white, or you can use all blue or any color you'd like. In this tutorial, I'm going to use blue with dark red instead of yellow. And silver looks really pretty too. Now we're going to start on making the beard, because you have to attach the beard to the head. So we'll do the beard first. I'm going to use gray and white. So it's a single loom, straight configuration, and everything is single banded. So I'm going to use white, single band here. I'm going to use gray in the middle and white over here. Then I'm going to put gray over here. If you don't want to use gray, you can just use all white also. And then I'm going to use white and gray. Then I'm going to use white over here, gray, and then I'm going to make a diagonal of white. So this thick part of the beard, now we're going to the skinnier part of the beard, which would be two colors. So I'm going to use white here and gray. Now gray and white. Okay, now white over here and gray. It's just a pattern. Now gray and white. Okay, and one more white and gray. Okay, so it's total of 1, 2, 3 rows of three, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows of double. Capping band, I'm going to use white, or you can use gray. I'm going to wrap it around three times, these two pins. Okay, now we're going to put some structural bands. I'm going to make different colors, so I used white here. I'm going to use gray here. Wrap it around two times, single band. I'm going to use white here, wrap it around twice, gray, wrap it around twice, white, same, twice. Okay, this one will be gray. Okay, now this is going to be a triangle band of white, and that is your beard. Now we can loop it, and I'm just going straight forward with this row. Now we'll start on this.